ورزقنا شفاعته يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ به تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي الهدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد فيا معشر المسلمين, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the major characteristics of a da'a, of somebody who calls to Allah and of a believer, is that they give advice, is that they are of the people who give nasiha, right? Being part of the people who give nasiha is a major commandment in Islam, and it's something that Allah tells us to do time and time again, and it is something that we see of the sunan of the anbiya, of the prophets, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, we see in the story of Prophet Nuh, right, when Prophet Nuh calls his people to Islam, what do they say? They say, Ya Nuh, inna lanaraka fi dhalalin mubin. They said, oh Noah, oh Nuh, we see that you are in plain error. His response, he says, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ لَيْسَ بِي ضَلَالَةٌ وَلَكِنِّي رَسُولٌ مِّن رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ أُبَلِّغُكُمْ رِسَالَاتِ رَبِّي وَأَنَا لَكُمْ وَأَنْسَحُ لَكُمْ وَأَعْلَوْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Nuh responds to his people and he said, oh my people, لَيْسَ بِي ضَلَالَةٌ, there is no error. But verily I am a messenger from Allah. I come, أُبَلِّغُكُمْ رِسَالَاتِ رَبِّي, I come to convey to you the message of my Lord and I give you sincere advice. Prophet Nuh is giving advice to his people. And in fact, in the story of Prophet Hud, the same thing happens. Right? They insult him and they call him names. And what does he say? He said, وَأَنَا لَكُمْ نَاسِحٌ أَمِينٌ, I'm only a sincere, I'm an advisor to you. Right? So in the stories of the prophets, we see time and time again that they call themselves, that they are advisors to the people. As such, it is incumbent for us as believers, as Muslims, that we advise people. Advice is something that is very important in our religion. In fact, Jabir ibn Abdullah says that when he went to give bay'ah to Rasulullah, right, he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I give you bay'ah, I testify that you are Rasulullah, and I have become a Muslim. What does the Prophet say to him? Yes, that is okay, but also amend your shahada to include that you will give bay'ah, that you give nasiha to the Muslims. Right, so he's becoming a Muslim. The Prophet said, that's great, but also make sure that when you're testifying that I am Rasulullah, make sure that you recognize that you have to give nasiha to the Muslims. In fact, there is a hadith, Ibn Tayyimiyyah narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ad-deenu nasiha. Right? The Prophet tells us that the religion, the essence, the crux of the religion is nasiha. Thus, it is very clear that nasiha is very important in our religion. When Shaykh al-Islam was asked, Ibn Taymiyyah was asked about how to get our life on the right path, a man came to Ibn Taymiyyah and he said, give me some advice, right? Elsie, give me some advice that will put my life on the right path. I want to know some words I can say, some actions that I can do, that by doing them, my life will become better. I can rectify myself, I can get a guarantee, I can feel safe, and inshallah, Allah will forgive me and I will go to Jannah. So what does he say? He says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, all praise shall be Allah, Lord of the world. He said that the best wasiyah I can give you, before I can give you any other wasiyah, I have to give you the wasiyah of Allah and the wasiyah of the Messenger. I have to advise you by that which Allah advises us to do, and I have to give you the advice that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives. So what is the advice that Allah tells us to do? What advice does Allah give us? Allah says in the Quran, بعد أن أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. Allah says that we have directed the people of the book, we have given them wasiyah, and you too, O Muslims, we are advising you to have taqwa of Allah, to be God conscious. Right? And what is the wasiyah of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? When the Prophet, he says, Mu'adh bin Jabal, he's sending him to Iraq to become a judge there. He says, Ya Mu'ad, ittaqillaha haythu kunt. The first thing he tells him, he says, Ya Mu'ad, you're going to become a leader in Yemen. The most important thing, the first thing you have to realize is that you have to fear Allah wherever you go. Fear Allah no matter what situation you are. Fear Allah wherever you are. Taqillaha haythu kunt. So from this you realize that taqwa and God consciousness is a major part of our deen. Right? Taqwa and God consciousness is what Allah tells us to do. Right? Allah tells us, I mean, why do we fast? We're in Ramadan. Right? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah says that I have كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْصِيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. That this month of fasting, you are fasting such that you can get God consciousness. So as such, it is very incumbent for us as Muslims to live our lives realizing that Allah is watching us. There's a story that we were taught, right, in which we have a sheikh and he has students. So he gives all the students, he gives them an apple, he gives them a fruit, and he said, I want you guys to go somewhere and eat this where no one can find you. Eat this where Allah cannot, even Allah himself cannot see you. So all the students disperse, right? One student, he goes under his bed and he eats this apple, he's like, oh, Allah can't see me here. Another student, he goes to his mom's closet, he eats it, he's like, oh, Allah can't see me. Another one leaves the town, another one goes to a mountain. All of them, they eat the apple except for one. So a while later, they come back and they're all like, oh yeah, Sheikh, we ate the apple, you know, we were able to find places where Allah couldn't see us. So he said, oh really, where did you go? So the first one says, you know, I went under my bed and I ate the apple. Allah didn't see me there. The second one says, I went to my mother's closet and I ate the apple. Allah did not see me there. The third one, and they all have all these stories about that I traveled far away and Allah didn't see me. And I did this and I went to that place and I went to this country and I went to that place. And Allah didn't see me, except for one. One of them, he still has the apple. Sheikh says, what happened? All of your comrades, all of your classmates, they were able to go and eat the apple, right? They were able to find places where Allah didn't see them. What about you? He said, yeah, Sheikh, I went under my bed, and I was about to eat the apple, but then I thought about it. And I realized that Allah sees me under my bed. So I went in the closet, and I thought about it again, Allah sees me here too. Allah's ever present. And wherever I would go, I could not find the place where I'd go except that Allah is constantly watching me. And the Shaykh said, yes, you have made it. Fusta, you have succeeded. This is taqwa. This is God consciousness. Taqwa is often translated, right? It's translated as fearing God. That's actually an incorrect translation. Taqwa is God consciousness. To have taqwa is to, in that everything I do, I realize that Allah is watching me. In fact, what is ihsan? Right? Jibreel alayhi salam, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَنَبِّئْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. Tell me what ihsan is. He says, أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ يَرَاهُ. To do ibadah of Allah as if you see Him, and if you do not see Him, then know that He sees you. Right? And the fuqaha discuss this. One of the gems that they bring out of this hadith is that ibadah is everything that we do to please Allah. Right? Ibadah is everything that I do to please Allah. So when I stand here, if I'm talking to a friend of mine, and if I have good intention, that counts as ibadah. Right? Everything I do can be an act of ibadah if I have good intention. That means that every action that we do, we have to recognize that Allah is watching us. This month of fasting, the entire reason we're told to fast is such that we can begin to inculcate this into us. It's such that we can begin to grow this God consciousness. It's such that we can begin to think about this every day of our lives. How many of us, we go through our daily lives, we never even think of Allah once? Right, we go to work, we use the bathroom, we eat, we do all of our daily things, but it never occurs to us that Allah is watching us. And it's not about hope or fear. It's about recognizing that Allah is watching me, such I have to have the best intention. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ به تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan is coming to a close. We are in the last 10 days of Ramadan. So we've talked about the importance of giving nasiha. And at the end of Ramadan, our teachers would always call us, especially when we did i'tikaf, they would always call us and we had a khatira, and if you give us advice towards the ending of Ramadan. One thing that we have to realize, that we may have not realized when we're coming into Ramadan, is that Ramadan is actually of two types. There's two aspects to Ramadan. The first aspect to Ramadan is Ramadan itself, the month of Ramadan, right? All the ibadah that we do in Ramadan, the actions that we're supposed to do in Ramadan, how we exert ourselves, we wake up in tahajjud, right? And we try to finish the Quran multiple times in Ramadan. And that's a part of Ramadan, the taraweeh that we pray, the fasting. All of this is actions that takes place in Ramadan that will benefit us. But another aspect to Ramadan that we often forget is that Ramadan is supposed to be a way for us to better ourselves. We're supposed to become better people after Ramadan. Ramadan is supposed to be a month in which we leave the month a better person than we were before. We're supposed to take something outside from Ramadan that we implement outside of Ramadan. And this is something that a lot of us don't take. How many Ramadans have passed in which I was the same person outside of Ramadan than I was at the beginning of Ramadan? How many years have passed in which I did not change myself for the better? That is not the best way we can benefit from the month of Ramadan. We as Muslims have to strive to take something from the month of Ramadan. Be it something that's really little. It could be I'm going to read a page a day. It could be I'm going to give a little sadaqah. It doesn't have to be a lot, right? Sometimes we think that, oh, to do anything I have to do three juz. You know, I have to change my entire life completely. That is not the case. What we need to do in this month of Ramadan and what we need to take out of this month of Ramadan is one action. We need to just learn one thing. Inshallah, I will try to pay tahajjud once a month. Just one time a month, and I will make this consistent, and Allah will reward me for it. Inshallah, I will try to fast on 13th, 14th, and 15th of the month, every month, inshallah. Right? These little actions that will benefit us and will change us. Because once you start these little things, every year you become better. You will see that in 50 years, you are much better, inshallah, tabarakallah. You are a much more pious person than you were today. Right? At the beginning of Ramadan, we had sins that we struggled with. Through the month of Ramadan, inshallah, tabarakallah, we were able to abstain from those sins. We were able to stay away from those sins. Inshallah, today we are better Muslims than we were at the beginning of Ramadan. And inshallah, at the end of Ramadan, we'll be better Muslims than we are today. So then let's keep this trend going. Let's not let Ramadan stop at Ramadan. Ramadan will not end at this Friday or this Saturday. We have to have a little bit of Ramadan continue. Be it the qiyam, be it the siyam, maybe it's salah, maybe you're going to pray two raka'at before fajr, maybe you're going to wake up for fajr, maybe you're going to try to pray isha in the masjid. The little things that we can do, we have to try to do it. We have to try to leave Ramadan better Muslims than we were before. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أحب الأعمال إلى الله أضوامها وإن قلت. The most beloved actions to Allah, أضوامها, the little ones, the more consistent ones, even be it small. Right? The Prophet tells us that we should give sadaqah even if it is with a half of a date. Right? Islam doesn't require us to try to change our lives to become monks. Right? It's about the little things that Allah loves. It's the little things that Allah cares about. And it is the little things that Allah will reward us for. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have to take opportunity, we have to take advantage of these final moments of Ramadan. Right? The scholars say that it is when you see a horse race, it is at the end of the race that the horse starts to run the fastest. Right? We are the final stretch of Ramadan. We are at this final run. We have to overexert ourselves. And after Ramadan, we have to keep the actions that we started going, inshallah. قل قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أيها المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وأكرم.